Hello and welcome to Web 101. First thing I want to impress on you is that when you're using a browser, in this case we're using Mozilla Firefox, but it really doesn't matter whether you're using that or Internet Explorer, whatever program you want, and you put in a URL, which is a web address, it basically goes to another computer located someplace else and asks for a file. And then it displays that file in a way that we can read. So right now we've got a browser and you see there's no web page in here. Now I want to show you something. When I type in, let's say Google for example, okay, and I come up with Google, you'll notice up here in the web address it says HTTP and two slashes. Well, that tells it that we're going to use a hypertext markup language, and you don't really need to know what that means right now except to say that's the language that most web pages are written in, and that tells it that we're going to request a web page. The next part of it up here, www.google.com, is where we're going to go to get the page. Now you notice there's no file specified in here, and this is an important concept I need to teach you. There's actually a default file. If I typed in index.html and I hit enter, you'll notice that this looks exactly the same. That's because whenever you type in a web page and you don't specify the file, it always assumes index.html. Because of that, the first page we are going to write for any web page is index.html. So whenever you get ready to write a web page, the first page, you're always going to save it as index.html. If you don't, what will happen is instead of just going to your domain and jumping to any old web page, it'll show a directory of web pages. And that's not a good thing. Everybody can see what you have in there. So now we're going to open up Composer. Composer is a free program used to write web pages. The nice thing about it, it's a what you see is what you get. So if I come down here to source, for example, this is all the actual HTML code that makes up the web page. Not very much right now, but we haven't really gotten started. When you click on normal, it's very similar to most word processors, and we'll get to that shortly. Composer has the ability for you to come in here and create multiple sites and upload your pages to the sites. However, being free software, it does have a little glitch to it, and that glitch is sometimes it doesn't always properly upload the data. So I don't use the site manager. We'll use another program called FileZilla, which will be covered in a later tutorial. So usually what I will do is I will close the site manager, which has the advantage of giving us a wider area so we can use 100% of the screen now to write our web page. So we'll begin. First thing we'll do is we'll just put in that title for the page. We'll just call it sample page or sample web page. All right, after that we need to have some text, and I am going to use what's called lorem ipsum. Lorem ipsum is some Latin text that's been used since the 1700s just as sample text, and you can look it up on Google if you want, but it's just some random text in Latin. It gives you the feeling of text without having something that distracts you. So we now have a basic web page. I can come up here and click on Save, and it asks for a name. This name is what's going to go up in the tab and what's going to go in the bar on the web's browser. So we're just going to put in here sample web page. Okay, then we're going to tell it OK. And what I always do is I create a directory called HTML, and inside of that I put my different web pages, my different sites, because I have multiple. It's a good habit to get into. It keeps you from getting things mixed up. And we're going to call this index.html because it's the first page that we're writing for this website. And we hit save. So now, if you look here, you see that there's some basic title, there's some text, and if we look at the source, you see it's got the header, which basically has some information to the browser about how it's going to be displayed. It has the title that we typed in, and then it has the main body of text with all of our text in there. And that's a web page in its simplest form. You'll also notice up here that it says body text. That means that everything on this whole page is just a body of text. There's no formatting or anything applied to it. Well, the first thing I would like to do is highlight this, and we're going to apply a format to it. And the format we're going to apply is a heading 1. And there's two reasons for that. One is it's a nice big text that's easy to read. The other is when you do a search engine, Google or Yahoo or whatever, they go through web pages and they look for the titles, and they pull that information and helps them determine the ranking and so forth. So you want to use heading 1 at the top of your page or someplace in your page that's prominent. You don't want to overuse it. So this is our simple web page. And we can hit save for right now. And if we look at the source by coming down here, you'll see that it's added these tags, H1, and then it's got an end H1. And that tells the browser, hey, when you get to this text, I want you to make it a heading. And when you finish with this text, I want you to stop making a heading. The nice thing about Composer is it does all of this for us. Another thing that we can do is we can apply something called a div tag. A div is a divider. So I can highlight this text like this, come up here, and I can give it this generic container, a div tag. And when I do that, you'll notice that this red line has now gone all the way around it. That means that this text is now subject to different things that we do to this div tag. And if we click on it, and you look down here, there's a div. I can right-click on that div tag, and I can click on inline styles. And when I do that, there's all kinds of things that I can do. I can say that I want this text, for example, to have a color, and I can specify blue. And when I do that, the text turns blue. I can specify a font size if I like. I can go to pixels, and then what I can do is I can increase the pixel size and make the text any size that I want to make it. And this allows us to have some great control over the text. Once I do what I want to do with it, I tell it OK, and I save it. This will now make the web page available to us to view on the web. And this is the simplest version of a web page that we can do. And it's not very difficult to attain that. Now, it's kind of boring, so let's look at adding some color to the page. One of the things that we can do is we can come up here to Format, and we can click on Format, scroll on down, and you see where it says Page Colors and Background. We can click on that and tell it to use custom colors. We'll go to the background, and we'll change it to a nice light yellow, and tell it OK. And you'll see now that the web page has a nice light color to it. Hit save, and the web page is now ready to be uploaded and viewed. And this is the simplest web page and concludes lesson number 1.